Hello friends from Wheelchair Gang, Sarah is here and welcome back to another Doctor Who leak video. But before we get into it, if you could do me a teeny tiny little favour and click that subscribe button, I would be ever so much appreciative. We are trying to get to 10k by the end of the year and I would absolutely love it if we could get there as soon as possible. We're about 90 subscribers away from 8k at the time of recording this, so if we could hit that over the next few days, I would absolutely love you forever. So this first one isn't exactly a leak as such, but I felt it important to mention it. I was going to mention it somewhere else, but I didn't really know where else to mention it, so I'll just mention it here. But basically, we've got a new Doctor Who sort of exhibition type thing. I'll read the tweet out to you now. Ready to learn about the science behind Doctor Who, a brand new science exhibition, Worlds of Wonder, where science meets fiction, will tour the UK from May 2022. So that's a very cool little thing, you know, a little exhibition thing. This is kind of the closest we'll ever get to having the Doctor Who experience back. May it rest in peace. I do find it somewhat amusing, however, that, you know, as soon as Russell T Davies gets announced to be showrunner again, we get the announcement of a new exhibition. Not saying that he had anything to do with it. In fact, this would probably have been in the works long before that announcement was made and confirmed, but it's almost like a sign that nature is healing now that Russell T Davies is back. On to our first actual leak then, or theory in this case anyway. This one's just called Production Timeline Discussion. Here's my thoughts for the most logical timeline. September 2021, filming complete for Centenary. January 2022, April 2022, Fall 2022, specials released. Mid-2022, production begins for Series 14. Mid-2023, Series 14 airs, November 2023, 60th anniversary. In July of 2009, Tenet specials were airing. Moffat had already begun production on Series 5, so this would not be uncommon as the productions do overlap, as they did in 2017 when Series 11 began filming in October when Moffat's production was technically not finished. So I think this is a pretty logical timeline. I would love it if we got a Series 14 before the 60th. I've said that before. I think it would be good to introduce a new Doctor before getting into the proper 60th celebrations, because then you can have a full-on multi Doctor story or something without having to worry about the fact that your new Doctor isn't getting enough time in the spotlight. Although, of course, I always feel that the incumbent Doctor in their era should be the forefront of the anniversary specials, just as Pertwee was with the Three Doctors, Davison was with the Five Doctors, and obviously Batsmith was with Day of the Doctor. Obviously, I understand there's been other multi-Doctor stories in between those times, but you get what I mean. Those are like the main ones. This next leak is called 60th Anniversary Clues. Now, everything is starting to make a bit more sense. I work for an agency that represents a number of actors, some of which are actors who have previously appeared in Doctor Who. I don't want to go into much detail of who exactly, as it will give my identity away, of course. About a month ago, we were contacted about the availability of some of our clients to film in 2022, for what I can only presume is the 60th. Anyway, the agency community is pretty tight, and I have friends who work for other agents who had similar contact. I am not going to pretend that I knew RTD was coming back, I had no idea, but now it's official he's doing the 60th. It makes sense that discussions have been going on between the BBC and him for a while, hence the inquiries. These actors from the classic series and a lot of their work at the moment is personal appearances, conventions, and in the email communications I have seen, they are beyond delighted to have even been considered for this and will, quote, make sure they are available. They love the show and have embraced it completely. It's difficult to get any concrete details, as availability is one of the first things established before their role is outlined to them, but we are expecting very rough details of this in the next few days or weeks. Don't get your hopes up too much, as they may turn the role down when they know what it entails. Happens more often than you might think. However, seeing how positive they were, it seems unlikely. I am seeing my colleagues at other agencies soon, so we'll try and see what the vibes they are getting. I'm sorry if this is too vague, I've got to be careful, but wanted to get this out there to reassure it looks like the plans for the 60th involve the whole of Who's history, not just the new series. Any bright ideas of how I can reveal more detail without giving my identity away would be greatly appreciated. So this one is, as they say, it kind of doesn't give away much, which inclines me to suggest that it's not legit. Although, they do make the point of, yeah, I just didn't know RTD was coming back, which I respect the honesty of, because I feel like a lot of these kind of jumped on the RTD bandwagon when it was announced. I do find it interesting that they make mention of specifically celebrating Doctor Who's entire history, as in Classic Who as well, rather than just New Who, as a criticism many people have. It's not one that I necessarily completely share, but I do see where it comes from. With the 50th anniversary, is that it's very New Who heavy and doesn't have a lot for classic fans. And if anyone was going to find a balance to strike between those two eras of the show, I feel like RTD would be the guy. He's respectful of all periods of the show, and I feel like he would want to pay tribute to as much of it as possible. So very exciting, the idea of classic Doctors coming back. It obviously, Your minds could be racing 4, 5, 6, 7. You know, David Bradley is the first Doctor. Basically, any of them are possible. Because although you might say, yeah, they're getting older, that could easily be written around the same way it was in Time Crash. Just say that the time distortion's gone all funny, and you're fine. So yeah, in my view, bring back all these classic actors while you still can. Now this next one, I'm going to call BS on straight away. It's basically someone saying that there's a production shot of Alex Kingston as River, and you can see it here. To me, this could just be from anything that Alex Kingston is in, and like, I've not seen this posted anywhere else, so I'm going to call BS on this. I feel like if this was legit, we'd have been seeing it all over Twitter by now, because with any filming, we all sort of see it like as soon as it basically happens, because people go looking at filming locations and stuff. So yeah, I'm calling BS on this one, but it's a good attempt by whoever did it. Now this is where things start to get a bit more spicy for our leaks today. So this one's called Doctor Who Series 14, Catherine Tate Returns as Donna. I feel like we're going back in time somewhat, because I feel like Catherine Tate, that rumour was like a big thing a couple months ago, because apparently she was spotted near the filming, but it was for something completely unrelated. Might have been that prison comedy she was doing. But now they're doing it again with Series 14, which I find rather amusing. It's kind of like how, for years, every year, Rose is suggested to be coming back. Okay, I've been wanting to talk about this for the last few months, but was trying to work out the right time to spill. I have heard of a friend who works in marketing in Doctor Who that the BBC and Russell T Davies are considering bringing back Catherine Tate as Donna Noble in Series 14 as a companion. Russell reportedly said that he wanted to bring her back at some point during his era, so it's perfect timing, really. I also know from my source that the BBC will announce her return at some point in the next few months, ready for her return in 2022. She has been in talks with the BBC over the last year and is delighted to be bringing her character back. That's all I know. I'm gonna, again, call sort of not complete BS, because it's not entirely out of the realm of possibility. Stranger things have happened, you know, RTD coming back being one of them. But at the same time, I feel as though Donna Noble's character arc's kind of complete. You'll all know her memory got wiped at the end of Stolen Earth Journey's End, and obviously it sort of got blown again in End of Time. So basically all that boils down to is that the Doctor can't really interact with Donna Noble again. And I feel like undoing that would go some way in undoing the dramatic weight of those initial scenes. So I'm not overly keen on the idea of Donna coming back, not because I don't think there's potential there, but more so because I just think her story like wraps up in such a nice way. I think it would be disappointing to try and do over that in a way that might detriment the initial narrative that we already have. Now this final leak is kind of the big chungus of the Doctor Who leaks that we've been covering so far in this video. It's called Why Chibnall Left and Why RTD Has Come Back, apparently. Plus new era info allegedly. I love apparently and allegedly, so it's like not even they're sure whether it's true. Hello r/Doctor Who News. I had some leaks. I thought I might as well share. I've received them from a source who claims to work for the BBC. So take this with a pinch of salt, if nothing else. Interesting to write about, but it seems plausible to me. Also, Therese might feature me. Oh boy, do I have news for you. So I received some info from the same person when Series 12 was about to come out. They told me about the Dalek special and how Sacha Dhawan was the master. I don't pay attention to every Doctor Who update, so this might be common knowledge prior to broadcast. All the same, since Series 12, I have been fascinated by what's coming next and how the BBC is perceiving the Timeless Child stuff. So I've been an avid watcher of Doctor Who leak videos, although I don't think any of them turned out to be true. Hey, my man! But yeah, you're kind of right, a lot of these don't turn out to be true. But that's what's the fun of them, you know, we get to dissect which bits seem legit, which bits don't. Anyways, I hadn't spoken to my source since the week Series 12 premiered, I believe, but I was hyped up by the RTD news and thought why not. They claimed to have known RTD was coming back, but supposedly this wasn't always the plan. Apparently BBC tried to get some others, Neil Gaiman, Neil Cross, Jed Mercutio and Sally Wainwright, were mentioned. None of them were interested. Basically they were asking anyone and RTD was the last person and they didn't even think he'd say yes. Interestingly, Pete McTeague wasn't even considered. That's good in my opinion. Like, I'm sorry, I know that Pete McTeague does a great job with the collection box sets, but I just don't think he's showrunner material at all. Like, his two episodes, you got Kablam and Praxis. Kablam's the stronger one of those two, but like, Praxis is just so dull to me. It's like, nothing happens. And also, like, you got the messaging of Kablam being kind of sus, basically, corporation good. Which, yeah, I'm not a fan of. But Anyway, as for the title of this post, it turns out Chibnall was talking nonsense when he mentioned a 3-year pact. He and Jodie were fully expecting to stick around for the 60th, but there have been some BTS behind the scenes problems, during Series 12 apparently, and BBC think he's lowered the bar for the show. Also, projections for Series 13 viewing figures are not great, apparently, so the BBC are throwing the towel with Chibnall. So the BBC are throwing in the towel with Chibnall and were desperate to find a good, reliable successor. Chibnall's only really big hit has been Broadchurch. No one was interested. Seems like the show has kind of been tarnished like it was back in the 80s at the BBC. But RTD wants to come back, not to just save the show, but also because he has some new ideas for it. At one point, he was actually slated to write a story for 2010, I believe, but he was too busy with the Very English scandal. As for the new Doctor, apparently they have been cast, or there are auditions, and they kind of know who, but not 100%. I mean, that's not the same thing. They're two different things, but fair enough. Or something. Pearson was pretty evasive, as I got the impression they weren't actually certain, but they know it's not Ollie Alexander or Russell Tovey, which is probably for the best, because I don't really see either of them particularly. Russell Tovey more so, mainly because I could see him playing perhaps like a more Matt Smith-esque quirky Doctor, but even then, I don't think he'd be ideal. The BBC do want a big name, apparently. At one stage, when they considered separate showrunners, Stephen Graham and Lenny Henry were suggested, as both have expressed potential interest. BBC kind of want a popular name like how Eccleston was when he was cast. Although, as RTD's coming back, they apparently aren't opposed to having a big name as a companion. Don't know who they'd cast, though. I mean, to be fair, they've been having big name companions since about 2017, because we had Matt Lucas, then we had Bradley Walsh, and now we've got John Bishop, so I mean, makes sense. Here are some names that they didn't confirm or deny, bear in mind they heavily insinuated it will be someone RTD worked with before. Out of the lesser names, Maxime Baldry, Lydia West and Tania Miller seem like the strong possibilities. I've said before, Tania Miller, I think she's a likely one and a decent choice. Lydia West I see more as a companion personally, but that's just me. And Maxime Baldry, I don't know too much about, but the rest they were evasive about were bigger names. Ask in comments if you know about others who might or might not have been mentioned. I can still ask, probably. So here we go. Rory Kinnear. Emma Thompson. I feel she's too big. I agree. I know she worked with Russell on Years and Years, but I still think that was like a one-off. James McAvoy. Could happen. He was on his Dark Materials, produced by Bad Wolf. Keely Hawes, Maxine Peake, Ruth Wilson, Andrew Scott, Ben Whishaw, Hugh Grant was RTD's original choice, and Gwendolyn Christie. Aside from that, I think Murray Gold is returning, and I think Jane Tranter is involved in some way, as is Julie Gardner. I'd actually really like Murray Gold to come back, because if you listen to his work in Years and Years, it's suitably different to his Doctor Who work, but it has a little bit of a Doctor Who flair to it. I think he could still bring a new take to the music. I know some people like Sagan, but personally for me, I'm much more of a Murray fan, so I'd be more than down for that. Also, there will be a seasonal special from RTD in 2022-2023, I think New Year's Day. Originally, Centenary was going to produce the new Doctor, but RTD didn't want to ditch seasonal special, and didn't want to introduce a new Doctor with two back-to-back specials. A series will follow then in spring 2023. That's optimistic, but I'd love it if it was. It will either be 8 or 10 episodes long, didn't confirm that, but it won't be 13 as it was back then. That makes sense because I think RTD said in interviews that killed him. Not literally, of course, but you know what I mean, like his workload was too much. RTD has been contracted for 3 seasons, but he has an open-ended clause where he could carry on at his own behest. The plan for the show going forward, ahead of RTD, to be produced by Bad Wolf, apparently RTD will try and find an heir, but that sounded a bit loose to me. Any questions, ask below. But yeah, this is an interesting one. Obviously, people might say that it's too early to know about stuff like this, like composers and stuff and Doctor choices. But like, there's been reliable people saying that, like, you know, the 14th Doctor's going through screen tests. And things like, you know, composers and stuff, they might have already been talked about. Because what you gotta think is that before these things are announced to all of us, they are thought about for a long time beforehand. They don't just drop it as soon as they make a decision. Things would have been considered beforehand, like the new period of the show that we're going to be entering into beyond 2022, that would have been spoken about well in advance. But how likely do I think that this is to actually happen? I mean, it's not impossible, but it's very vague. Like, obviously, you know, a lot of the names seem likely because they've been on like His Dark Materials, which is a Bad Wolf production, or Years and Years and It's a Sin, which is a Russell T. Davis production. But again, I've said this before with the RTD one specifically, it's hard to know whether or not like they're accurate because how much of this information is just true information at this point. I find it interesting that they make note of the fact that Chibnall wasn't meant to be leaving and that the BBC kind of sort of shuffled him out. Is what the impression I got from that, which has always kind of been my suspicion anyway. Not saying it's true, but it wouldn't surprise me if it was. The idea of there not being a new Doctor introduced in two back-to-back specials, I kind of get, but I also don't really see much of a difference between having two specials to introduce a Doctor and having a special and then, an introductory episode or whatever. Ultimately, either way, you're gonna get to see the new Doctor. I personally would like to see the new Doctor in the Centenary. This doesn't seem to suggest that, but personally for me, I think I like the tradition of seeing the new Doctor beforehand. And I think it would just give peace of mind that, the show is actually gonna continue. Obviously, we know it is now with RTD, but I just mean, like, it gives you something to hold on to for the future, you know what I mean? But let me know what you guys think about these leaks in the comments below. If you did enjoy this video, be sure to give it a like, comment down below your thoughts, and subscribe if you're new. Thank you for watching, and I will see you later.